Hi guys, good evening, hope you're well. So what's cropped up recently, just in conversation and stuff, is about muscle and a few of people's worries about potentially putting too much muscle on. And then on the flip side of it, people wanting to know how much muscle they think they should be putting on a week by week basis or a month by month basis. And then I kind of want to finish off on what I think from an exercise point of view. I won't touch on the nutritional or kind of lifestyle factors, which I think help with muscle building, but specifically what I think from a exercise point of view that you will need to focus on when you go back to the gym or when the gyms reopen. Now that's not going to be too far away. Once Boris pulls his finger out his backside, you'll be able to kind of get back to the gym. And I believe if you focus on these things, or certainly change your perception in a few ways on how to approach muscle building, then it can really help you and it can really change you. So first of all, I want to talk about the kind of individual who's worried about putting too much muscle on. Now, specifically, without trying to stereotype too much, this is probably talking about the female client, okay, quite a bit. They're worried about looking too broad around the shoulders, or just generally getting too muscly, and looking quite masculine. Well, the fact is, girls, it's kind of, I've never really seen a masculine girl that's kind of not been assisted, or, you know, so not been on things like steroids and things like that. So I wouldn't worry about it too much. You produce roughly around 6 to 8 times less testosterone and growth hormone naturally than the average male, and males struggle to put muscle on. So that's another kind of reason or justification not to be too worried about putting muscle on. And even if you do put muscle on, girls, I hate to keep saying girls, it's not just girls, it's guys as well. But even if you are worried about putting too much muscle on, and if you do put muscle on, it doesn't mean that instantly you're going to kind of blow up and look masculine. You can actually look a lot leaner, a lot more athletic, a lot more visually pleasing and more attractive by having more muscle on your body. Okay, now, a lot of people, the ironic thing is that the people that are scared about putting too much muscle on, the actual people that they want to look like are actually doing weight training. They're actually focusing on putting more muscle on. And there's this like misconception that if you do weight training or if you eat too much protein and stuff, you're gonna look masculine. Well, the actual people that the scared people are that wanna look like certain individuals, they're kind of their idols are the ones that are actually doing the weight training, they're getting plenty of food on board and eating for their bodies in a way, and that's the ironic thing about it. So from that perspective, I would never be too worried about putting too much muscle on, and like I always say, it's in your interest to try and put as much muscle on as possible from a quality of life perspective. Just from the fact that, you know, I went on earlier today and talked about sarcopenia, which is an age-related loss of muscle mass with age. Okay, so you can actually make great strides into preventing that by introducing weight training and by trying to put muscle mass on. So it's definitely something that putting muscle on you shouldn't be worried about or scared about. Okay, and then on the other end of the spectrum, it's kind of the people, so specifically males, who are desperate to put muscle mass on and putting a lot of muscle mass on. Well, unfortunately, you need to kind of set yourself in. You need to kind of dig a bunker out. You need to dig a trench out, and you need to settle in for the long ride. Now, yes, sure, you can make great strides and you can accelerate the process, but putting muscle mass on and making it appear that you've made massive visual changes is going to take time, and it's going to take a lot of consistency on your part, a lot of perseverance on your part, a lot of dedication and a lot of commitment, and it's going to involve trial and error through nutrition, making sure that you're eating enough and that you've got everything right so that you're eating for you and eating for your body. And then it's going to take a bit of trial and error with the training to make sure that that's working and that's firing on all cylinders as possible. So there's that element as well, which unfortunately, you know, changing a physique and changing the way you look to make it look a dramatic change, it takes time, and you've got to be prepared to kind of sit in. And we're not just talking months, you know, we're talking years here, okay? So that's the reality of it, basically. Now, there's all this going around at the minute about kind of what's the best exercise for improving this body part, and things like that, and what's the best exercise for putting muscle on in this area, etc. And granted, there are exercises which will help develop certain areas of the body and that that you will need to focus on, and certain bits of equipment that will be best suited for that, etc. But I think it goes beyond that, or I think you need to address certain points before that, before you start thinking, okay, what's the best exercise that I need to be performing for that body part. Now, just for the whole body as general, if you want to develop your physique and build muscle all over your body, there's, in my eyes, there's three kind of areas which you need to focus on. Okay, the first being consistency. Consistency in continually turning up to the gym and consistency in performing the same exercises for a long period of time. So this is what I find people struggle with. They start chopping and changing different exercises. Granted, you can slightly change exercises to hit muscles from different angles and things like that, but you need to get into the routine of performing the same exercises for a long period of time. And then only through constantly hitting it with that same stimulus time and time again will it start to develop the way you want to say you want it to develop. If you're only giving it 3 or 4 weeks on an exercise before you start to change, then yeah, it'll still develop, but it needs more exposure of the same exercise on that. So that'd be the first thing: consistency in the exercises you perform, and also consistency in just consistently showing up and making sure that you're frequently working out. The second one would be, what is your intent and what is your purpose of the session? Okay, so it's so easy, you know, you've just been 9-to-5 job and then you've got to get to the gym and you're shattered, you're knackered, and it would be so easy just to kind of rock up at the gym, perform a few exercises and go through the motions with the exercises without really thinking about what you're doing, without really thinking about what you're working towards, or without you really thinking about how you're performing those exercises. Where if you show up with purpose, like first two exercises tonight, I'm gonna PB them, or I'm gonna try and PB them. So that is your focus, and that is already lifting the intensity of the session to making sure you're getting the maximum out of the minutes that you're spending in the gym. Okay, and intent is like thinking about contracting muscles. So if you're performing a bench press, you're actually thinking, I say to clients, you're putting your brain into your chest and trying to contract that muscle as much as possible. And believe it or not, that has a massive impact on how you contract muscles and tends to benefit it massively. And the third and final one, which kind of would fit alongside what I've just mentioned, would be execution. Okay, so before you start thinking about, oh, this exercise is best for this area, well, it's only the best exercise for that area if you execute it properly. If your execution is piss poor, okay, for that exercise, then that area isn't going to develop how you want to develop, because other muscle groups will get involved and you'll end up not targeting that area. So execution is of massive, massive importance. And the problem with execution comes 9 times out of 10, dropping your ego. Because when you execute an exercise properly, you will not be able to lift, most of the time, as much weight as what you were lifting before. So there becomes the old ego element there of, you need to be able to drop your ego and actually start to think, let's go back to basics, let's do things properly, let's execute the exercise efficiently to maximally stimulate the muscle, and then just watch it develop, okay? Because if you're able to maximally stimulate a muscle, you're gonna get the most out of that exercise, your performance. Remember, when it comes to muscle building, when it comes to body composition training, it's not about making workouts efficient for you and efficient for your body. It's about making workouts as inefficient as possible. It's about making exercises as inefficient as possible. So in other terms, it's about making exercises as hard as possible for you. Granted, that will involve sometimes increasing the weight, but first of all, focus on making the execution of the exercise so good that it ultimately demands the most out of your body and the most out of that muscle that you're targeting at the time, that it maximally stimulates the muscle that you're working. So there are just a few kind of things that obviously work well for me and work well for my clients, and are certainly things that we as coach and client obviously talk about and work on. It's simply, you know, when it comes to gaining muscle, granted there is other aspects to it, like the nutritional element, and there's the lifestyle element as well, things like stress, things like sleep as well, which can help. But just from an exercise point of view today, if you focus on consistency with exercises you perform and continually showing up to the gym, if you work on having an intent and having a purpose when you show up to the gym, and if you make it a massive priority to focus on execution of the exercise and doing it properly, then you are going to get so much more out of your workouts. You're going to get so much out of each set, each exercise you perform, and also you're going to watch your physique start to change and start to really take shape the way you want it to take shape.